Hi, welcome. I think my voice is loud enough without this, but I'll be a good girl. So welcome, and you are really in a special place, and it's special anyway, but it's special because the purpose for which it was had its second life is connected with the purpose that we're here today. So let me tell you. So this was somebody's home, and you're in what was the music room of a man called Sir Lionel Phillips. He had this home built for himself and his wife, Sir Lionel and Lady Florence Phillips. And this is where they lived. It was built in 1909, so it's over 100 years old. And if you come in the front door, and I'm happy to take you for a little walk later when we're done, you'll see it's got a heritage plaque. It's a real national heritage site. And Sir Herbert Baker designed this home for them, and then he actually didn't finish building it for them. He went to build the Union Buildings. So you know that this was designed by like a real echte person. Anyway, they lived here until 1922, and a lot of cool things happened. So they were the founders of the SPCA in South Africa. Lady Florence Phillips actually was the founding person of the Johannesburg Art Gallery. And you'll see when you walk, if you've been to the Loo and you've walked around the house a little bit, it's filled with art. The whole campus is filled with art because our shareholders are passionate collectors of South African and African contemporary art. So the art is all over, and it comes from the history. So they lived here until 1923. I have to read, I can't remember dates. They lived here until 1922, actually. And in 1923, they had sold the building to the South African Jewish orphanage. And so this place, and I actually get the shivers, this place was home to 400 orphans until Hollard bought the campus in 2003. And the orphans were predominantly, they started from Europe during the war. And if you stand outside and you look at the boards, those are all the donation boards that helped to create a home for those orphans. The good news story is that by the time Hollard offered to buy the property, the Jewish orphanage was ready to sell it because actually they had so few kids that needed to be housed in the orphanage. And it's actually moved off-site, Sandringham, actually near Summerwood, and it's a home to much fewer kids. So that's why I say it's a full circle kind of story, because we're here today about the children, and this place was a home to children for so many years. So when Hollard bought the campus, we built this property that side, and this is a very much alive space. This gets used all the time for meetings, for training, for all sorts of things. It's really not like an old relic that nobody touches. So you really can stomp on the floor. This place loves a bit of noise. This is a gorgeous place. It was, like I said, Sir Lionel's music room. In fact, we had an art function here the other day, and there was a piano in the corner, and the acoustics were incredible. I was going to tell you something else. Oh, during the time it was the Jewish orphanage, this was also a synagogue. So it's got a very spiritual feel, and a lot of people have walked in here and said, there's something about this place. This is a good place, and it's a good place to host you all who are my friends in doing good stuff, and I'm happy to have you here. Thank you.